I've never changed that, so.
Mr. Henderson?
Good morning.
Yep.
How are you?
So I am.
What is she saying?
She's good.
But anyhow, I just thought it was interesting to, in the past, there were some chickens.
I heard that. It doesn't take, you saw in the budget here.
From my stomach.
Doesn't take much to trigger.
Yeah.
Morning, Eric.
Hey, Jen.
How are you, my dear?
Good.
I was still getting too close, I had to run higher, but I'm scared. What are you up to? Saw a picture of you with kids on the Facebook. Pretty interesting. Is one of them almost finished with college?
One is already 2 years old.
No, which one?
Not looking to.
What's he doing? Where does, is he living in?
He's on this poetry.
Yeah.
It's considered the line of death. That's what I always do.
Do you need to read this code?
No.
Hey, I should look for some. Okay, what about?
I'm serious. Left her hair on her and she's already going.
Everyone's on.
You know, to be honest, it's probably.
Where's your phone?
It's not. If you get.
Hello.
When you get. That was where you were at with my kids. Yeah. So where is she still in Roswell?
Yeah, she's.
Exactly.
Yeah, you see where it's. I don't remember where it was she got in.
Oh, okay.
Still play, she's still writing, I suppose.
No, mostly we lose someone writing a little bit.
On my beard like. He's a very.
Oh, okay.
We'll let you see.
The more it is hard, constricted, is the opposite of what you draw, what normally. So I know at least that I will.
My neighbor, who was the first cyclist I've ever seen. And how? At any rate, he had a dental issue.
Ready?
And,
all right. All right, I think we're ready to go.
He dropped in a heart attack. While he's riding his bicycle.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Ready? My name is Marley Press, I'm the city clerk here at Roswell, and we received a challenge from Mr. Fleck on February 6, 2017, and I'm going to read it into the record. The basis of his complaint is that Shelley Sears had violated state code O.C.G.A. 21-2-132F1, which states that when a candidate files a notice of their candidacy, they must also file on the affidavit, which includes, among other things, his or her full name. It further states that the candidate must use a surname that appears on their voter registration card, which Ms. Sears has failed to do. On the affidavit filed by Shelley Sears to run in this special election on March 21st, 2017, she states that her legal name is Shelley Thomas-Sears and requests that her name appear on the ballot as Shelley Sears. Her voter registration card is in the name Shelley Thomas. And before I continue, I just want to set down some little rules here. The candidate and their attorney or representative are the only ones that will be able to speak. There will be no public comment allowed, and if there are any outbursts from the public, you will be removed. That is all I have for that, and it says that on the code, for the code that he's talking about, it says that the surname of the candidate shall be the surname of the candidate as it appears on the candidate's voter registration card unless the candidate provides proof that his or her surname as it appears on the candidate's registration card is incorrect, in which event the correct name shall be listed. So what we want to do, we'd like you to swear her in. Swear her in first.
Yes, ma'am. My name is Shelley Sears. Okay. I have the honor and privilege of representing Ms. Sears here today before you. Ms. Sears, would you raise your right hand? You solemnly swear to testify the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to help you guide these proceedings?
Yes, I do.
Okay. So what we want is do you have any proof that shows that your voter registration card is incorrect?
No.
Well, you do have proof that the voter registration card is...
Well, it's...
clarified by the basis of the fact that, and I think the thing to do, Madam Clerk, is to go through a history, if that's okay, with her name. Miss Shelley J. Thomas is her maiden name. She was married in 1980 to Mr. Nathan Sears. And there's nothing in the law that I have looked at that requires her to use that married name until she desires to at her request. She was licensed in 1978 with the Georgia Board of Realtors, and her original license was in the name of Shelley J. Thomas. That changed in 1980 when she married Mr. Sears to Shelley J. Thomas Sears, according to the Georgia Real Estate Records. She then incorporated her Shelley Sears team when she began selling property in Roswell around that time. I think it was around 1985. And when she signed her candidacy, she provided the city of Roswell with her full name, Shelley J. Thomas - Sears. She signed it Shelley J. Sears, and she listed her name as how she wanted it to appear on the for the voters as Shelley Sears. She has provided the city subsequently with an affidavit that has clarified the issue, and I believe it was brought to her attention that there may have been some confusion as to the number of months that she's been, or the number of years she's been a resident in the city. And she had 2.7, and I read it as 2 years, 7 months, but it could be easily confused as 2.7 months, so she clarified that by affidavit, in which she also clarified her legal names and what she is known by. So we would suggest that she's done everything she can by providing over information. And in addition, we have a copy of her marriage license here for you. We have a copy of her tax returns that shows that she's filed in the name of Shelley J. Thomas Sears. We would request that if you want to retain copies of the tax return, you redact out the, just keep the one page that shows what her name is and redact out her social security number, unless that's already public record, which I don't know. But for all practical purposes, as the statute is written, she's allowed to, excuse me. Oh, yes, she's saying that her husband's name, who is now deceased, his social is also on there, which should be redacted as well. So we've got all kinds of documents from the Georgia Real Estate Commission, tax bills, marriage licenses, everything that you need to know as to who this person is. She's not trying to hide anything.
And the death certificate.
The death certificate of her husband, which shows her legal name as well. So everything's been provided. There's no intent to do anything untoward with the city or the taxpayers. And it is what it is.
Can we take those documents? We were just going to scan them. We can just scan them and she can take it right back, so. Yeah, that's not bad. We'll scan them. Check those back.
Yeah, can you give us this as well, social security card?
So for the record, can you tell us exactly what you're submitting, the documents you're submitting?
I believe I'm submitting my birth certificate from Michigan, which is where I was born. I'm submitting a copy of my social security, which says Shelley J. Thomas, which is what I got when I was 16 years of age in Wisconsin. I'm submitting my banking license that the state of Georgia investigated and gave me a banking license for a couple of years. And the copy of the license are there with the letters, and you will note that the banking department of Georgia addresses me as Shelley Sears, even though they know what my full name is, because they have to look at that. I've highly been looked at by all parts of the world. And then in there is my real estate license, front and back. It shows what year I was licensed in Georgia. Just a standard joke to you all, I was licensed very early in my life. And when people compare my number to everybody out doing real estate, they think I'm dirt. You know, I'm that old. Because I think it was like 4,600 brokers in Georgia. So that kind of gives you an idea how long I've been around. And I also believe I'm giving my husband's death certificate, which happened last year, and I am giving what else is in there, dear? May I look?
Or your marriage license?
My marriage license, yes. I think that's everything I'm presenting to you.
And the tax return?
I had not given those, but they're binded, and do you want the last page, front page? How would you like? Do you want the e-file page?
Just whatever would have your name that the IRS.
This would have it. Well, that's Georgia. Do you want Georgia?
I think you should have both.
Okay.
I want that.
Please redact that.
Oh, for sure.
That's 2015's tax returns. Thank you. And then I just wanted to show some longevity that I had been. So the last one that was in my file was 2001. So that's basically 15 years that I filed with the identical exact name.
Y'all care for this one as well?
Thank you. And both times that I was in front of Marley, I presented my driver's license, which is in the name Shelley J. Thomas.
Thank you.
you intend to change your voter registration card?
Yes.
Yes. Which means I have to change my driver's license and my passport?
You need to change the voter registration card to reflect the accurate name so that the statute satisfies.
Okay, then yes, I just have to.
And we would submit that the way that 21-2-132 is drafted, it's to me as an attorney, it's vague as to whether that is a necessary step, but I think it should be done. But the way I read it is, if the record is corrected, which could be corrected for purposes of handing another affidavit or handing other information showing who she is to the city of Roswell, I would contend satisfies the statute, but we will absolutely change your voter registration card. So there's no hint of not the lines.
Yeah. I mean, the statute itself just says, you know, unless the candidate provides proof that his or her surname, as it appears on the candidate's registration card, is incorrect, and that you know the correct name check your list. So I don't think there's an affirmative duty. Like you said, I agree with you on that.
Oh, Fulton County, when I went to Fulton County, because I'd come back into the city of Roswell and had to go down and file. I mean, I've paid all the tax bills since I was through, but Fulton County, when I went in to sign whatever paperwork had to be signed because I was changing my address and moving my primary residence out of Cherokee back after my husband passed away to my home that I have here in Roswell, they asked for full documentation and they did not question anything about what my legal name was for the tax exempt. And of course this year I'll be turning 65 on April. Woo-hoo.
I would just like to add to perfect the record from a legal standpoint that I have tried in the last day and a half since I was notified about this to scour state law. Started with the Georgia Constitution. There does not appear to be anything in the Georgia Constitution that would prohibit a candidate from running based upon an error in a name. There is a specific statute, 45-2-1, that specifically tells what people are ineligible to hold office, and it deals mostly with residency requirements, age, felony convictions, things of that nature. Nothing to do with name issues. I've looked at two separate cases. One is Haynes versus Wells, 538 Southeast 2nd, 430, which is one of the only two cases that I've been able to find, and it dealt with a individual who attempted to move into the 5th District for a local election a week before qualifying and was specifically disqualified, and the basis of that case said that the driver's license does not qualify you to vote because he simply tried to change his driver's license. And the court said the driver's license doesn't qualify you to vote because that needs to be transmitted to the county, to the state, and then to the county for the voter registration purposes. So I would submit that any name on her driver's license by correlation does not disqualify her if that is incorrect based upon that case. The last case is Spillers versus State. It's a Court of Appeals case, 299 Georgia Appeals 854. It dealt with a individual who had a felony conviction, but he pled nolo. He had notified the clerk of the county as to the conviction. The clerk contacted the Secretary of State and cleared the fact that he was okay to run. Charges were subsequently brought against Mr. Spillers for fraudulently false swearing, essentially, based on the fact that he had a criminal conviction. And the court, which I think the salient part for this is that the essential elements of false swearing are willfully, knowingly, absolutely, and falsely swearing under oath or affirmation upon a matter as to which a party can be legally sworn and on oath administered by a person legally authorized to administer it, the intent to testify falsely, and the falsity of the testimony. again, in this case, there was no intent. All of the information was provided and over-provided so that the city could have all the information on Ms. Sears' name. And what the court held in Spillers was that he was swearing only that he was not disqualified from holding public office by reason of a felony, which was subjectively true and was objectively correct under the applicable law. And we would state that subjectively, Ms. Sears had no intent to violate any law or misrepresent herself before the city. And objectively, there's nothing to keep her name off the ballot based upon Georgia law, the Georgia Constitution, and the information she has subsequently provided to the city of Roswell last week or a week or so ago and today. That's all I have.
That's really all we have. We'll take all the information under advisement and render a decision probably within 24 hours.
Thank you. Thank you. And if we could just wait to get those documents back, that would be helpful.
Oh, yeah. This hearing is closed.
Thank you.
Thank you. Don't make sure you get it. Okay.
Well, those are yours.
Those are the original.
Oh, okay. I see. You're saying you unstaped them to get them.
Yeah, we had to in order to scan them.
I got them, dear.
And then this is yours.
We don't need to scan. This was our copy, right?
Yeah, that's her copy. Robin made it.
Okay. Thank you for us.
I've never thought about binding my tax return before. That's a good idea.
Just nothing else is not organized. It has to be.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm fully embraced of how it's going to appear on the town to with Fulton County.
She's sitting
still. No, I got the answer. The definitive answer is that her name will be on the ballot. But anybody that votes for her, that vote will not be tabulated. So it's a wasted vote for anybody who, and her campaign signs are all up on her ballot. Most people don't know, and this is why I thought of the letter saying, the legal instrument of Roswell needs to definitively notify the public. Now, at the polling location, there will be a sign saying that this individual has has disqualified herself for us. And I assume that Tracy Henry's people will be on that.
I wish I was going to.
But appreciate your interest.
I want to see the beat.
I think they said a lot.
Oh, well, that's okay.
No, not on the ballot.
So her name will just be on there?
No, her name will be on there like anyone. They cannot change the name because there are some big names that they are. No, there will be a banner at the polling location saying what individuals disqualified themselves from the election. That's the only thing.
And it actually says the statute.
I'm big difference.
Some of the statutes.
But I appreciate it. Pursue this as quickly as you can. Sure, thank you.
No, she's going to go to trial. Prosecutor, she's going to get that. I'm not helping you this morning.
Thank you.
This is Mike Liz.
Hey, Shelley. Pleasure to meet you. Yeah.
Mike was a.
I'll see you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, I'll talk to you.
That's perfect.
I know that.
Thank you so much.
And Ms. Michael and I.
Hey, Mike.
Remember you many, many moves ago.
It was a long time ago.
Fulton County Commissioner.
You and I were a lot younger then.
I spoke in front of you. I'm doing some work for Martin's Landing.
Oh, okay.
Paula Waninsky, way back in the day.
Paula, yeah.
Before we, that whole area was on.
Treated you right.
I think you all did. I think you did.
Coming from Fulton County, it's, it could be anything.
Yeah, it was, yeah, it's a little different, but anyway, good to see you.
It's you too, sir.
Yeah, Mike coached my son in soccer. And he got to do it.
Daniel.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah, because this is the one I just had Robin.
Congratulations.
And I'm suing him.
Well.
For term limits violations.
He's the founder of Bike Roswell, believe it or not. The organization I was president of.
I thought you were the founder.
No, I was second president, you know, Frank.
Eric gives me credit.
It's totally his, I'm standing in line to vote and Gary's in front of me and I'm like, oh, you got ripped a new one by Mike, you know, and Mike wrote the editorial that said, there's less bike lanes than when I helped the mayor get elected and he got elected based on getting more bike lanes. And I'm like, and so I'm talking to him about that. And he goes, yeah, we're going to do something about that. Next thing you know, I get a notice to come to a meeting right here. And we started Bike Roswell and I was on the initial board and then they asked me to be president and things started to happen. So
thank you, Eric.
I get enough exercise just walking my side.
Thanks, Smith. I'm a little bit that way.
Thank you, ladies.
Thank you very much.
Have a great day.
Same
to you. See you tomorrow.
Hi, I'm
Shelley.
I get where I'm going. It will all be good because, and a few people have said she's smart, she understands what's going on, and there will be quality.
Yeah, well, I hope you understand what I meant by that.
Yes, yes. It's all right. I know how it all worked.
I couldn't do one without the other. Because it was both the same situation, you understand? It was nothing personal, just strictly business.
Sweet. Peace. We've got, mm-hmm. Hey, we're good. This is what we're here to do, is, you know, and I'm one of these people, you'll find. I do my homework very, very, very thorough, and I don't make irrational decisions. I am blessed by wonderful people that meet, like you and I meet. We're, you know what I'm saying? We're meeting now. This is going to be a relationship. So, okay.
You have a good day.
You too, sweetie.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Oh, by the way, this is my son, Casey.
Hi. Casey, how do you do?
Nice to meet you.
Pleasure meeting you. Have a good day.
Yep.